Welcome back. Now we have the pleasure to have this phone with Dr. Mustafa Rajab, the president of the Egyptian community in Europe. Welcome, Dr. Rajab.
Thank you very much, and welcome to everyone listening to the Egyptian station. And despite the distance that we have between us, but we have listened to the speech for the president and his congratulation to the Egyptian people and the Egyptian army in this occasion. And he also stressed on the unity between the people and the army and the police. We all one hand. This is very important in this important time of Egypt. Also, I was so pleased to listen to him warning the Egyptian people of all the wrong rumors that enemies of Egypt is spreading around and using the social media and using their own media to make the Egyptian people think of what they've showed him. People in Egypt should share the truth in front of their eyes, on land, in Egypt, in everything happening. People should listen to the international world. Now, talking about the Egyptian economy reviving and improving, they should look at the infrastructure in Egypt. They should look at all these great achievements and be proud of it. And we are there to support you. We are here today outside the Egyptian embassy in London to send the strongest message of support to our land, to our president, to our army, to our Egyptian people. Despite the long distance between us, we live with you. We live with all your problems. We live with your celebration. We live with you. We feel for you. We are there for Egypt. Whatever happened, whenever happened, we are all together to support our country.
Yes, Dr. Rajab, since you've listened to President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi's word address today to the nation, the president said that the victory of the 6th of October war is a turning point day in the history of Egypt that combines the past with the future and is a crossing line between desperation and hope. How do you see his words?
If you follow what happened in Egypt since 1973 until today, and what happened before 73 as well, we lived all this time. We've seen, we've witnessed everything there. We've seen our neighbors, our friends, our relatives who sacrificed their life for their country. We've seen everything. So we know exactly what's happening in Egypt. Today, we send our condolences to all the families who lost their loved ones, and we tell them we feel for you, we are with you. We are here today to send our message to the country,
yes,
to the president, to the people of Egypt. We are with you. We are supporting you. We're standing against everything that people trying to do against Egypt abroad. And your responsibility is inside Egypt. We're taking the responsibility outside Egypt. Today, as a matter of fact, all the countries in Europe are coming together under one umbrella to say we respect, we love the Egyptian flag. This is an initiative that started from Belgium and also has the support of the Ministry of Immigration. And we are all together today under the Egyptian flag in the love of Egypt. And the message is loud and clear to everyone outside Egypt and inside Egypt. Egypt will live. Long live Egypt. Long live the Egyptian army. Long live the Egyptian president. God give him the patience. God give him the stamina to carry on during this very difficult time.
Yes, I thank you very much, Dr. Rajab, for your great words. But actually, let me ask you, you as the president of the Egyptian community in Europe, what is the role that you play on such a day, a significant day in the history of Egypt, which is the 6th of October and the victory of the 1973? How, what are the activations held, the events that are held on this occasion? Welcome back. We are still with our phone with Dr. Mustafa Rajab, the president of the Egyptian community in Europe. Dr. Rajab? Dr. Rajab?
Yes, I'm with you.
Yes, Dr. Rajab, as you are the president of the Egyptian community in Europe, what is the role that you play in such a day, the 6th of October? Are you holding events or celebrations for the Egyptians there?
All over Europe today. Everyone in his country, in his capital, is having an event, getting together the Egyptian people in their country, whether it's in France or in England, in Belgium, in Germany, all over Europe. We're all having the same event at the same time. We're all coming together to send the same message loud and clear to everybody from the Egyptian, not just in Europe, but actually from all over the world. So the events are there. People are celebrating, people are sending their best regards and their support to our army, to our president, to our people in Egypt. We're saying to them, stand up for the difficult time you are going through. There is nothing easy. Don't just listen to people telling you all these rumors about Egypt. Egypt, in the eyes of everyone abroad, is doing very well. But things take time. You need to have unlimited patience. If you want to build your country, if you want to see your country great again, it will be built with your support. It will be built with your patience. Stand by Egypt.
Yes, Dr. Rajab, as Egypt won the war of the October 1973, it is also struggling in a war against terrorism and against rumors on social media.
Let me tell you something.
Yes.
During the 1973 war, I was in London.
Yes.
And I was lucky enough to see everything live in the English television and seeing all the victory the Egyptian army achieving and seeing all the worries and the fear in the eyes and in the voice of the Israeli army and the government. We've seen every day Mr. Zayat in the United Nations refusing the ceasefire. We're seeing every day Israel and America asking for ceasefire. And El-Zayed, God bless him, refusing the ceasefire. We've seen when the war stopped and why did it stop. And this clever decision from President Sadat that he was not going to sacrifice the Egyptian army because the American people have put new weapons in the battlefield that you cannot do anything about it. So it was like committing suicide to carry on. So his decision at the right time and achieved the best. Look, all the Egyptian lands now are free. And if the Arab countries have listened to President Sadat, they would have achieved the same. But we can't say anything about it now. Now we are where we are. And we'll have to deal with it. We have to make sure that our Egypt becomes strong and great, and the Egyptian people, the future is for them. Yes. They need to know that the future is for their next generation. They have to build for the next generation.
Yes, I thank you very much for joining me and for your time, Dr. Mustafa Rajab, the president of the Egyptian community in Europe. Thank you very much for your valuable information. Ladies and gentlemen, a short break. I'm going to be back with you.